Hello everyone, in this video we are going to be looking at case X and case Z. The first one is case X. So here it treats all X and Z values as don't cares. So if it is written like this, 2b1x, so this X can be 0. See, this x can be 0, this x can be 1, this x can be z, okay. So 2b1x is equivalent to 2b10, because x can be 0, 2b11, here x equal to 1, then 2b1x, x equal to x, and 2b1z. It treats all x and z values as don't cares. And if it is written 3b1xz, then it is equivalent to 3b100. This xz can be 00, 01, 10, 11. So this can be 31. This is equivalent to 3b100, 3b101. This value is fixed. This one is fixed. Okay. So what is changing is this xz part. 00, 01, 10, 11. Or this can be also 3b1xz, okay. Then in case of case z, it treats all z values as don't cares, and all bit position with z can also be represented by this one, okay, the question mark. So if it is written 2b1 question mark, means this question mark can be 0, it can be 1, it can be x, it can be z, okay. So it is equivalent to this 2b1 question mark is equivalent to 2b10, because this one is fixed. It can be 10, it can be 11, it can be 1x, or it can be 1z. But if you have written 2bx question mark, then here x is not replaced by 0, 1, x or z. This x is fixed. See, it treats all z values as don't cares. So this one is z value, means here all the bit position of z can be represented by this question mark. So this question mark equal to z. So in this case, 2b1, this one means 2b1z, okay. So now this z can be 0, 1, x and z. So in this case this question mark, so x is not going to be changed, okay. This x is fixed. Here the x can be 0, it can be 1, it can be z, okay, or it can be x. But here in this case only this z part is going to be changed, okay. So here 2bx, the question mark is equivalent to 2bx0, so this is the z one, okay. This question mark is z here, so it can be x0, x1, xx or xz, okay. So this first bit is fixed, and the last bit it is changed to 0, 1, x and z. Here x and z are allowed in case statements. That you have to remember, there's inside a case statement x and z are considered. So this is case X and this is case Z. Okay. So let's see an example. So raise 3 is to 0 encoding. So this is a variable, encoding variable, which is 4-bit. Then integer state case X. See, the first one was case X and the second one is case Z. So here case X encoding. So logic value X represents a don't care bit. Okay. So now it is. So inside the case, we have these expressions. Okay. 4b1 triple x, 4bx, so these are the statements. Then default end case. So for example, here if encoding equal to 4-bit, encoding equal to 4-bit 1, 0, x and z, and it is case x, okay. There is difference between case x and case z. This is what I have explained here, okay. Case x and case z, here x is treated as x here x and z values as don't cares. It treats all x and z values as don't cares. So here in this scenario, in this case, 4-bit 1-0 if encoding equal to 4-bit 1-0xz, then it will match to which one? The first one, second one, third one, or fourth one, or default one. Okay, let's see. So this one will be the first bit is 1, so this 1 is matching. Okay, so it won't be considered because here it is x. So this one will be matching. Okay, this one, so 1, then what it is written here, it is x. So this x can be 0, this x can be 1. See, 1 is matching, the first one is matching with this one. This is encoding. Okay, this is encoding. Then the first statement, 1 x x x, so 1 is matching with this one, then x. So in case of case x, the x can be 0, it can be 1, it can be x, it can be z. So this 0 it will match. Then this x can be x, 1, 0, so this will also match. Then z, so this x can be 1, because all these are don't cares. It can be 1, it can be 0, it can be x, it can be z. Okay, so this one, so the first one will match and next state equal to 3. So it will give you next state equal to 3 and it will be executed. This line will be executed, the first one. It is not, the rest of the expressions are not matching, because here first one is x, here it is first bit is 1, so it is 1 is matching, it is matching with the first one. So this line will be executed if it is case x. And in case of case z, it can be different. Okay, here a case versus a case x. So there is example here, a module case c, input 1:0a, output range, always at the red. Here it is a case x statement. Okay, this is a case x and this is a case. So, and this is test bench for this one. The first one is at 0 nanosecond a equal to 2 bit 00. So when it is 00, let's see, when it is 00, the first one is, this is 1, so x can be, it is case x, so x can be, this 1x means this can be 10 and this can be 11. Okay, in case of case x, this x means it can be 0, it can be 1. Okay, and this 1x means in case of a case, inside the case we have 1x. And this 1x means it is always 1x. It cannot be 10 or it cannot be 11. Okay, it is always 1x. Inside the case, it is always 1x. Okay. And do you remember this line actually? Here it is written, x and z are allowed in case statement. So here, inside case, we have written x. Okay. So first one is at 0 nanosecond. Input is 00, a equal to 00. So nothing is matching. There is no 00 here. So default will be, it will consider default one. So b equal to 0, c equal to 0. So output is c. Output is b equal to 0 and c equal to 0. The second one is a equal to 01. After 10 nanosecond, it is a equal to 01. A equal to 01 means, is it matching anywhere? 01. There is no 01. See, 1x, this 1x means it can be 10, it can be 11. And here case 1x means 1x only. So there is no 10. So it will consider again the default one, b equal to 0 and c equal to 0. See, b equal to 0 and c equal to 0. This is a test bench result. It is a test bench result. Okay. Then after 10 nanosecond again, it is 11. The input is 11. 11 means it is matching here. C. 11 is matching, so b equal to 1, and here there is no matching, so c equal to 0. B equal to 1, b equal to 1, b equal to 1, this one, and c equal to 0. See, b equal to 1 and c equal to 0. Then 0x, there is no 0x, right? There is no 0 here. There is no case x, there is no 0x case also, there is no 0x. So default will be b equal to 0 and c equal to 0. So here default is b equal to 0 and c equal to 0. Then 1x, is there any matching 1x? 1x, it is matching here. This b equal to 1, here also it is matching c equal to 1. So it is b equal to 1 and c equal to 1, see. Then xx, a equal to xx. A equal to xx, is there any match here x x x x, there is no x x, so default will be b equal to 0 and c equal to 0 x x. Oh, sorry, here it is a equal to xx. Xx means it is inside the case x. Okay, sorry. This is inside the case x. So this xx means it can be 1x also. It will consider 1x also. It will consider 0x also. Okay. So this one will be b equal to 1. B equal to 1 and it will be c equal to 0. Okay. This one will be b equal to 1 and c equal to 0. Because this xx, inside the case ax, the xx can be 1x also, it can be 0x also. Okay, so it will match b equal to 1. Okay, then the next one is x0 means this x can be, see, x0 means this x can be 0, this x can be 1 inside the case x. Okay, so it will match, so it will match to b equal to 1 and c equal to 0. So it is b equal to 1 and c equal to 0, because in the case there is no match. Okay, so c equal to 0, so it is c equal to 0. So what we learned here is, if something is written inside the case, this is a match. If it is 1x, if 1x comes, then 1x will match, and other than 1x nothing will match. Okay, but here this x can be 0, this x can be 1, this x can be x, this x can be z also. Okay, but here in case of case, it is pure 100% matching. 1x means 1x only. If it is 1z means it is 1z only. Okay, this is how it works, this case, and this is the case x. Okay, so this is all about case and case x and case z. Hope that you understood the difference between case and case x and case z. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video, and if you liked it, then you can press the like button and you can subscribe this channel. Thank you.